folklore sprang up alongside the rich German folklore and is much a cultural adaptation by those early Jewish people as anything else. The German people had a lot of folklore, so they came up with a lot of folklore. From there, the
scarfs
spread across Europe and
moth.
Europe. It's not so shocking that Gary Gygax would think to include golems in the first edition of the game, as is we think that background traced straight back to Switzerland. But this, by this not our modern age, golems are fairly well-known mythic creations across countless tales. For example, the golem found in the pages of Terry Pratchett's Discworld novels, Feet of Clay being a particular favourite of mine. A common theme in these tales of golems is exploitation of the power of creation and the lack of due care in its use. This is one of the main reasons creating golems in D&D is so difficult and expensive. A caster can, in theory, make an unlimited number of golems and set them to tasks.
It's going up his nose.
Being able to control only a small number at a time, such as the case with undead, and why hordes of undead created and controlled by just one caster are almost unheard of. Undead are also vulnerable to being turned and destroyed by clerics and such, while golems have very few vulnerabilities. While it is true that instructing a golem to act takes away the actions of the controller, these simple instructions can be followed by the golem without the controller needing
to. He's still got it alive.
The first golems created in D&D,
nope, I don't think anymore.
Primordials, entities, and later the divine gods both have the capacity to create other beings out of raw matter. The golem has long been a source, a simple version of this process, later becoming stolen knowledge used by the lesser, the living creatures of the mortal world to create artificial life. The giants and the dwarves were particularly good at this. Elves concentrated more on vital energies and the flow of elemental forces, and
pretty dusty
dragons, who are conduits of elemental power, as well as by their own nature. Giants created titanic constructs during the genocidal war against the dragons.
Rock and roll.
This construct called Wannendot stood 30 feet tall and was humanoid.